In this video, we will be implementing the discrete Fourier transform and fast Fourier transform on MATLAB and calculate their speed. So this will be the code that we will use for the calculation of DFT and FFT. First, we have defined the number of points in the FFT, capital N equals 1000. Then we have defined small n equals 0 to n minus 1, meaning it will be from 0 to 999. Then we have defined the sampling frequency, fs equals 10,000, and then we have defined the time of sampling. Sampling time is ts equals 1 over fs. It is also known as sampling period. Let's consider an arbitrary signal x of n equals sine 2 pi 1000 into nts plus sine 2 pi 3000 into nts plus cos 2 pi 0 into nts plus cos 2 pi into 2000 nts. And then we have plotted the signal using a stamp function. But then we have defined x of k, capital X of k, from zeros to zeros, 1 comma n. So what this will do is create a variable in which we have zeros of length n. Now tick function is used to start the clock, as we will like to calculate the time for the calculation of DFT and FFT. As defined in the one of the previous videos, this function is derived from the equation, from the analytic equation of the DFT. We will use two for loops for the calculation. And then we have used the turn off clock TOC that will stop the clock. We have defined a variable k equals 0 to n minus 1 for the plotting. Then we have defined a new figure, so it will open a new figure. And then we have used stamp again to plot the DFT, magnitude of DFT, using the absolute function. Now let's compare the equation that we derived on MATLAB with the analytic equation of a DFT. We have two for loops for k equals 0 to n minus 1 and for n equals 0 to n minus 1. Then in the loop we have x of k, k plus 1 equals x of k, k plus 1 plus x of n, n plus 1 into exponent minus 1i. This is equivalent to minus j into 2 pi k n over n, just like the analytic equation we have up there. K is the index of FFT and n is the sample which is multiplying by exponent. So as the inner loop completes its iterations, we will have the value of xk 1 and so on. As the outer loop completes its iteration, we will have all the values of x of k. Then we will look to calculate the fast Fourier transform. Fast Fourier transform can be calculated easily using MATLAB because of built-in function, using just FFT in the signal and the number of points for calculating the FFT. And we have stored it in the variable FT. And in the same way, we have used tick, and we have used solve for the calculation of the time. Then again, we have to find a figure, new figure, and then stamp the output of the FFT as well. Now let's run this. So as you can see, we have run the program. This is a figure 1, so this will be the original signal that we have defined. This is the original signal. This is the FFT discrete Fourier transform naive method, and this figure 3 is fast Fourier transform. As you can see, both have the same result. Well, now let's look at the time of calculation that each algorithm took. As you can see in the command window, we have the output here. For calculating the DFT, it has used 1.175 seconds, and for calculating the fast Fourier transform, it is used around less than milliseconds to calculate the FFT.